Wake up!
What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Married to Film. I'm Ralph, and this is Shimonda.
Hey.
Right now, we're at Season 4, Episode 6 of Cobra Kai. This one's called Kicks Get Chicks. Let's go ahead and get into this one, baby.
Okay, baby.
Welcome to the annual Old Valley Tournament Board meeting. We have a lot to discuss. Last year's tournament was epic. It's time to take it to the next level. We want to make sure that karate in the valley gets the respect and the honor it deserves.
Can I please calm down and keep this professional?
Enough of this bullshit!
Oh, it might be bullshit to you, but some of us here actually care about tradition.
Oh, don't go there again, George.
Clearly, the blue mats led to a surge in attendance. Why would we go back to the red mats?
Aisha! Oh, she's coming back!
So let me get something straight. We're sanctioning an event where boys are encouraged to kick and punch girls. Have any of you thought for a moment this could be perceived as problematic?
Man, don't get me all hype if Aisha ain't gonna come back.
Remember, this proposal will revolutionize the tournament. This is our legacy. By a show of hands, do we all agree on the changes? The motion passes by unanimous support. It's time to step into the future.
The All Valley Committee just announced big changes for the tournament.
Kind of changes.
Well, see for yourself. It's a whole new ballgame.
They're introducing skills competitions.
Yep.
Kata, board-breaking weapons display?
There's going to be a separate girls' division. So that means...
there'll be two All-Valley champs.
But wait, so what does that mean for the bet with Cobra Kai?
There's a grand champion trophy for whichever dojo wins the most points.
All I know is the girls' division is mine.
You don't have to breathe too much. There's a black mold in the corner.
Look, Sensei, I know things got heated at Miyagi-Do, but with these new changes, I think having Sam on our team would really help.
So maybe if you could talk to Mr. LaRusso.
I have nothing to say to him, all right? We're better off without him. It's time for us to take care of our own business.
All Valley champions.
Don't worry.
I'm sure.
This is just perfect. First, LaRusso and Johnny Lawrence split. Now this.
Come on, I'm from heaven, baby.
And neither one of them have the fighters to compete in both divisions.
We're going to win this tournament before it even starts.
Where would you like this, Mr. Cooper?
What's all this?
Top of the line gear to go with our new state-of-the-art equipment.
Yeah, I got treadmills.
These kids need to see we settle for nothing but the best. Now is the time to show our strength.
You're a hard girl to find. Avoiding your Annie Candace now, sweetheart? Ignoring my calls?
Now, what do you want?
Well, to see you, of course. And to ask if my sister's disability came in yet.
What, need funding for another scan? That money's for us.
Come on now. My sister always promised to take care of me. She taught you better.
Yeah, she taught me to recognize a low-class leech.
Mind your manners. When your mom kicks the bucket, who do you... quick temper. Just like your old man. When your mother passes gracefully, then what? You think your daddy's just gonna show up out of the blue? I'm all you got.
You don't get a shit about us. You just want her survivor benefits.
I was at little Bobby's 4th birthday party just last year.
Brandon is 8. And next year I'll be 18.
What do you think's gonna win a custody battle, huh? You're a high school dropout and a criminal.
So are you.
Yeah, and I know how to play the game. A judge is gonna take one look at you and laugh you straight out of court. See you at the funeral, sweetheart.
Whoa!
Wow.
Tick-tock.
Wow.
Oh.
This is it. This is where most of the girls' teams practice. You sure you're gonna be able to convince them?
No.
Please, when I went to this school, the only thing I was better at than karate, and I was pretty good at karate, was talking to chicks. Watch and learn, Diaz. Watch and learn.
No! You're a perv!
Teen girls want it. Gotta be under 18 or it's a no-go. No, not like that!
Hey, Miguel.
Hey, Mina, what's up?
Apparently some perv is creeping on the track team, so we're gonna practice unsafe.
Oh, God.
What are you guys doing here?
We're just recruiting for our new dojo.
Eagle Fang Karate.
Yeah. You know, you should join, actually.
Really? Okay. Yeah, that sounds like fun. Wait, do I have to hit anyone?
Hell yeah, you do.
No, then I'm out. I can't do the whole physical aggression thing. You know, you guys should ask my ex.
Hawk? Yeah.
No, my other ex. She's the best athlete in school, and she's not afraid to get into a fight.
Sounds like the badass babe we've been looking for.
You might want to take a different approach with her. Want some pointers?
Absolutely.
Oh.
She knocked this time.
So you're knocking this time.
Mrs. LaRusso, I need your help.
Yay! Oh, I'm about to cry.
Come on in. So the principal said he'd consider letting me back into school because of my situation at home, but your family would have to sign off.
Oh no.
Well, I'm glad you want to get your life back on track. Going back to school is a big step, but I need you to promise me something.
I'll stay away from Sam. I swear,
that's great.
Well, Sam ain't gonna promise that.
I want you to get support. Talk to someone. You've been dealing with a lot. You have been. For a while, you should talk to a therapist, a guidance counselor, the Dalai Lama. It doesn't matter. Just someone who isn't karate related.
Whatever it takes, I'll do it.
Uh-oh. Here we go.
And you're going to be fighting against lots of new opponents and...
What? What the hell is she doing here?
You're the Hawk.
Yeah, not anymore.
Hey, at least it looks better than the last time I saw it.
Well, not school knows what happened. It's embarrassing.
Who cares what they think? Besides, it'll go back.
It doesn't matter. I ruined my reputation, I talked a big game, and then just proved I was an asshole.
Wow.
To Moon, to Miguel, and especially you.
Wow.
I got what I deserved.
Hey, I forgave you, remember? And I don't care if you have a mohawk or a mullet or pigtails. Miyagi-Do needs you.
I'm not going back to Miyagi-Do.
You're choosing Eagle Fang over your best friend.
I'm not going back to Eagle Fang either, alright? I'm done with Karate Man.
Wow.
She's fast, she's strong.
Girl's a natural eagle.
Oh, which one is yours?
Oh, that one looks good to me. I haven't talked to her yet, though. Still working on my approach. You got any advice?
Oh, my God.
Remember what Moon told you? Yes, I will be awake.
No. You can't be around. Students.
Hey.
Yes, fluids are crucial.
Oh!
It affects performance.
He didn't get it.
From you.
Well, actually, I have been meaning to join your dojo. I don't want to be the last person in the valley who doesn't know karate.
Well, then today is your lucky day.
I know you think that mohawk defined who you are, but it didn't. Not to me. Eli, Hawk, hell, call yourself Cornelius for all I care. None of that changes the fact that you're my binary brother. Either you're number one or zero.
Robbie.
Are you stalking him now?
Okay, that's
of course. This will only take a minute. No, I can save you that minute.
Lookie,
you're here because you realize you're training a bunch of wimps and you need a male champion, right?
Uh-oh.
Let me guess, your sales pitch is, I'm here to rescue you. This isn't who you are, Robbie. I can help.
Oh, no.
Blah, 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 blah.
No.
I've said all that before.
Uh-oh.
It's time to break the pattern. I heard what you did to Eli. I just gave him what he deserved. I'm not here to judge you. I'm here to tell you what's going to happen to you next. Terry Silver just popped up out of the blue, right? He did the same thing to me. He'll seem decent enough, show you a few moves, and then he'll worm his way in, chip away at you, and push you past your limits. You'll become stronger than you thought possible, but Silver won't stop there. Okay, this man is sick and twisted, and when he's done with you, you won't be you anymore. One day you'll find yourself with some poor kid's blood all over your shirt, and you'll just hope it's not too late to change course.
He's not interested, Mr. LaRusso. New equipment just got in. Why don't you go check it out? It's considered unethical to poach students. You had your opportunity with Robbie, now he's with us. You should respect that.
Respect? You are not a sensei. You're a con man. Manipulating people to turn them into something that they're not.
I didn't turn you into anything, Danny boy. I only brought up what was already inside.
That's bullshit. You tortured me.
Please. You were a hothead. All I had to do was wind you up and get out of the way. And if you're being honest with yourself, you know you liked it. You were powerful, free. You just don't want to admit there's always been a little Cobra Kai in you.
We'll settle this on the mat. And when we win, Cobra Kai and you will be out of business.
One of us will be.
Oh no.
She's at Cobra Kai. She's at Cobra Kai.
Yeah.
Told you.
Nothing but the best for the best. Can't wait to kick ass with Team Cobra Kai.
She joined Cobra Kai.
Looks like they made a bunch of designer gear for all the new students. They got a bunch of new recruits.
Yeah, great. So that was just a big waste of time. I even learned feminism.
Look, we can't give up, Sensei. If we want a shot at first place, we have to compete in the girls' division.
With who? We don't have Cobra Kai's money. We have no chance of finding a champion for the tournament.
Whoa.
I wasn't a champion when you met me. Hey, you made me when you saw something in me that no one else did. Hey, maybe you just have to see that in someone else. We just have to think outside the box.
Go get Aisha!
Wherever she is.
Bring her Where back, Cobra Kai!
Get outside the box!
Aisha!
Ah! Oh my gosh! Oh god!
I can't believe you drove all the way to Santa Barbara.
Yay!
I can't even live in Santa Barbara. Your house is beautiful. Thanks. My dad got a job offer from UCSB that he just couldn't pass up.
Wait, so the fight at school had nothing to do with it?
Oh, it had plenty to do with it. My parents were pissed. I broke a kid's nose. Who knew these things were lethal weapons? But you didn't drive 2 hours to talk about the butts I've kicked. What's going on?
Tori wants to come back to West Valley, and my parents just want me to be cool about it.
We're talking about the same overprotective LaRussos who made me wear a helmet on your trampoline?
She told him some sob story.
When I started my new school, there was this girl in my homeroom. She gave me a look that I'd seen before. She just knew she was gonna be my next bully. But I wasn't gonna let the cycle repeat itself. So I walked right up to her, and you know what I did?
Is this gonna be another front-witchy story?
I introduced myself.
Yeah.
I even told her I liked her shoes. When I didn't, but it seemed like the polite thing to do. I told her I was new and I asked her if she could introduce me around.
How'd that go?
She's my bestie. My new school bestie. You'll always be the OG. I attacked my problem head on. I struck first. I set my own terms. Set yours.
Aisha!
Sensei, what are you doing here? I thought the day was for nerds.
It is, which is why we're ditching it. You're right. I'm not giving up on the girls' competition. Think outside the box. Figure it out.
What do you got? Something stupid.
Completely full of crap. His evidence is garbage, his arguments don't make a lick of sense, and I was bored to death. Which is ironic, considering we're debating the death penalty.
You're not gonna deduct points for lack of decorum?
A screw decorum? Wanna know what I really think of the death penalty? My book! Choke on it. I see my time.
Sensei. That's the girl I told you about. What's extracurricular?
Get it, Bert. I just found the most badass girl in the valley.
Look who decided to come back. It's good to see you, Eli. Or is it Hawk? Doesn't matter. I'm just here to do what I can to help out the team. Oh, that's good. The more help, the better. Good to have you back. About yesterday.
No, Dad, it's fine. You and Mom were right. It's time we leave the past behind us, right?
Yeah. I'm proud of you, Sam.
Ah,
you
sure did that!
It's never easy being a big person.
My girl.
I'm coming for you, bitch.
That's a nut. That's a dream.
Right. Maybe not.
So she just flipped it. That's not what Aisha told her to do.
Right.
She said, use the fundamentals. And use it to your advantage.
Right, right,
use the lessons that you have learned. Nobody said for you to go and threaten somebody. She's vulnerable right now. She don't even know what the girl's doing.
Mm.
She don't know what is going on in her life. She was like, oh yeah, so she just got a little sob story and won over my parents and all this kind of stuff.
Right.
Who cares what she said?
Right.
Blah, 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 blah. That hurt my feelings. We seen Aisha.
I know, right?
I'm so excited about that. I was hoping that she would come back and kick some booty, though.
Mm-hmm.
But that... Sorry. The whole... The whole trying to find logic behind her anger thing. She has good reason. The girl cut her.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, not just a fight, not just a fist fight,
mm-hmm.
but she had a weapon too.
Mm-hmm.
And the PTSD kicked in, you know, from that. And now all of a sudden she's flipped that. It's not anxiety, it's just straight anger. So she's angry toward the girl. Okay, that's fine. Be angry toward her. Whatever, whatever. But you may have to let bygones be bygones. I mean, the prime example that they had was LaRusso and Johnny working together.
Mm-hmm.
At least at one point, they were mm-hmm. able to, you know, thrash all that and just be like, you know, forget it all and just say, okay, let's at least get along for right. the sake of the kids.
Right. That's true.
And I think they forgot about that because...
I think so, too.
They started all over again.
Mm-hmm.
But I think they're going to come around.
Yeah, I hope so.
Hopefully. But, yeah, go ahead. I'm sorry.
So the episode started with the new change in the rules for the tournament. That's going to be an all-girl division.
Please, I forgot about
so,
that.
So now Johnny is trying to find a female... for Eagle Fang, and he was being a perv at the high school.
Okay. Was he not?
Oh, that was funny, though. But he ended up finding, well, he thought he had one. Thought he had, what's her name? Is her name Moon? Uh-huh. Moon's ex-girlfriend, he thought he had her, but she joined Cobra Kai. Just so happens he had to happen to be at a debate with, show up to the debate that Miguel was at and was going to pitch him an idea about having somebody dress up as a girl when they think they found their female. So we shall see if they're able to recruit her. This episode was good. A lot of lessons, letting bygones be bygones pretty much. Aisha giving nuggets out.
Yay.
The interaction between Sam and Amanda, Tory and Amanda. That was good. Yeah.
And then we also found out that Amanda's...
has a crazy aunt.
Amanda.
I mean, not Amanda, sorry.
That she had a misdemeanor that caused her not to be able to walk across the stage for graduation. But not only that, but she was like, yeah, so I took a bat to... some lady's car, and Danny was like, oh, okay, yeah, with her in it though. And so the charges that she had from that, he said he didn't know anything about it, and she was like, yeah, that's not the kind of thing you want to bring up on a first date. Then I have a misdemeanor. Yeah, if I have another strike, I'm going to jail,
right?
Like, that kind of thing on a conversation, you just don't want to do that. But so she relates to Tory on a different level than mm-hmm. her and Sam would ever relate to.
Mm-hmm.
But if Sam goes in the same pathway that she's going, she may end up on parole. I mean, on probation. You know, it's just a whole different thing going on. I didn't know what to say. All right, but we're going to keep going.
Yep. So let us know what you guys thought of the episode. Don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe.
Do all that.
We'll see y'all next time.
Yep.
Love y'all.
Love you guys. Bye. Hey, wake up!
Thank you.